Hello and welcome to 5th Java training tutorial. In this tutorial we are going to focus on a couple of more aspects of Java which are required to be able to work with Selenium. So let's have a look at the content of this training session. So we will see enum type, we will see how we can have enum with and without parameter, how we can create enum in IntelliJ, we will see iterating through values of enum, how instance initialization can be used. We will also see switch statement and of course couple of Selenium examples. So let's begin with it. So this is our old project, and in this project I have made few modifications and we are going to use those modifications or classes today. So I have created a package called classes and objects, and in this we have an enum called country. Now how you can create an enum? Just right click on a package, say new class, give it a name. You can type any name, say I type temp now, and select type as enum. So I will not click OK because I have already created an enum called country here. So what's an enum? Enum gives us a capability to define parameterized constants. Say for example, in this enum I have few countries defined, and how the declaration goes is we have access specifier which is public here, so this enum is accessible to whole world. The keyword is enum, and then we have the name of the enum which is country here, and then we have the enum constants. So in this case I have four countries listed here which are France, Italy, Germany and UK, and these are known as enum constants. Alright, so later in the tutorial we will see how we can use these enum constants or enum type country. So this is an enum where we do not have any parameter. Now let's have a look at another enum where we have parameters. So this is another enum which is modified country, and in this enum again we have the four countries but we have them parameterized. So for example, France has two values, French and Paris, and so on, and at last we have UK with English and London. Now how does this parameterization work? So let's have a look at where does control go if we click on say France. Okay, so control comes here. So here we have constructor for the enum which is very similar to the constructor of the class. So the name of the constructor of enum is same as the name of the enum, and then we have couple of arguments being passed to it, and these arguments are the same arguments which are being used to parameterize this enum. So we have two arguments here, namely language and capital, and we have two instance variable in this enum which are declared private, which we had seen in initial chapters or tutorials that we should declare instance variable as private to support data encapsulation. So we have them declared private here, and then we have two getters using which we can fetch their values. Alright, coming back to the constructor for the enum here, we have language and capital being passed as an argument here, and then these are used to initialize the instance variable of the enum which are language and capital here. About the this keyword here, we had seen its usage in the previous chapters or previous tutorials that we can use this to distinguish between the instance variable and the parameter which is passed in a class here, in the constructor here. So this completes the example of parameterized enum wherein we have enum as well as its initialization happening where enum constants are declared. Alright, so let's have a look at how we can use this enum in our test, but before that I would also explain you how we can use switch statement, because we are going to use switch statement in the following test class. So here is our test class. Alright, so let's see what we are doing in the test class. As again we have the main method here, we have instantiated the Firefox driver, and we have defined the wait period of 10 seconds, which means if there is no element on the page, then web driver will wait for 10 seconds for element to appear. Alright, so let's see what we do here. We have created an instance of Google homepage here. So if you recall, we had defined the Google homepage class in our previous tutorial video. So if you have missed that, then please watch that video first so you will understand what is there in Google homepage class. Let's get back to the test class. Yeah, so here we have Google homepage instance variable created, or object, sorry, not the instance variable, the object created, and then we are trying to get the name of the Google homepage class here. But we are really not interested in this test class. In fact, we want to see the enum test class, so I will move to the enum test class. Let's see what's happening in enum test class. Alright, so this is similar to the previous test class. Here also we have Firefox driver declared, but we have not instantiated it here. And then we have Google homepage class object created. And then we have Firefox driver being instantiated in this block. Now let's understand what is this block. So earlier we had seen that we can use constructor to initialize the instance member of a class, but here we are using an initializer block. And this initializer block begins with open parenthesis and closes with close parenthesis. And in this we can initialize all the non-static instance variable of class. So here we have one non-static instance variable as Firefox driver, so I initialize it here. You really don't have to use the initializer, you can also use the constructor, but I just wanted to show you how you can use initializer as well. Now let's come back to the next method in this class. We have a method called run test on given local, and this method takes a parameter of type country. So country is the enum which we declared here, and let's see what happens in this class, in this method. So in this method it takes the type country, and now we can iterate through different values of country here. So we have a switch statement here. You can compare switch statement with if then else, but it provides many branches of iteration. So we say here, okay, switch over country. Now let's see what's next. Let's see what type of country it is. So then we have a keyword called case, and if country is France, then we are printing that run Selenium test in France, and then we are doing a Google search on keyword or on the data Selenium user group in France. So this method Google search, Google homepage dot search, is defined in the Google homepage class. Let's get back to our enum test class. Yeah, then we have second case with Italy, and in that case we are doing search for the word Selenium user group in Italy and then Germany. And then we have a default case. So if we pass a country which does not satisfy any of these cases, then the default case is run, which says that this is not a valid test country. You can compare this with a real-time testing scenario where your application is tested in many locales and some of the locales are not ready. In that case, the control will come to the default statement here, and you don't have to run test in a locale which is not ready for test. Alright, so all of these case statements also have a break statement there, which means that if one case is satisfied, then control will come out of it, so it will not go to next case statement. If we do not use the break here, then control will go through each of the case statement, which we really don't want. So this was about using switch with type enum. Okay, let's come down further. We have another method here, which is search country attributes, and here we are passing argument of type modified country, which is again an enum. This is something which we saw here, which is a parameterized enum. So let's go back to enum test class. Yeah, so here we compare what is the language of the country which we are passing. So we have, if you recall, we have a get language getter in the modified country enum, so we get it from here. And then we compare if it is English. So if it is English, then we are doing two Google search operation. One search operation is on the language and another is on the capital. Alright, let's come down further. And then we have shutdown statement, which is to close the Firefox. Alright, then we have our main method. So in main method, we will try to use all of these methods which we saw over. So we have instantiated our enum test class here, and we have an object now called enum test class, and then we launch the Google homepage. Now let's see what happens next. So we have a couple of print statements, and now we will do a valid test for Germany. So how do we do that? Let's create an enum object here. So we enum object. So let's create an enum object here. So we have country as the name of the enum, and then we name it as country one. And how do we specify the value here? We say country dot whichever country we want. So it is country dot Germany, or we can say country dot UK or country dot France. So these are the countries which are defined in the enum country. So this is a way to instantiate an enum. And after this, we want to run test on given locale. So locale is country one. So from here, control will go to the method which has the switch statement, and then we will have the iteration happening here. We will see this when we run the test. Let's come down. Yeah, Then we declare a second country here, country reference for type country enum, and this is UK. And then we have again call to run test on given locale method, and then we are passing the reference country to it. Okay, let's come down further. Then we have iteration through the values of enum. So we are using for each loop here, which we had seen in earlier sessions. Now there is a special method here called values. If you see, the values method is nowhere defined in countries enum here, but this method is supplied from the compiler, which gives us all the values which are associated with an enum. So we can get all the values from this, and then we assign it one by one to each enum variable, which is country here, and then we are printing the values. So this is how we can fetch all the values in an enum. And then we have our last print statements, wherein we are creating an instance of modified country here, and then we have UK instance being created here. We could have created instance of any of France, Italy or Germany as well, but we are creating instance of UK here. And then we are calling method search country attribute, which we defined earlier. So the control comes here, and then we have a couple of statements being executed there. All right, and then we shut down the driver. So let's run this program and see what happens. I have kept the debug points already, so it would help us in visualizing the test. So here it begins. And here comes the Firefox. All right, so control has come to first breakpoint. And if you see here, the first search is on Selenium user group in Germany. How this worked is, since we have declared country as Germany, then control will go to our method here. And then here control will check what case is applicable, and we know that country is in fact Germany here. So control comes down, and then it comes to case Germany, and then it runs test on Germany, and the test data there was Selenium user group in Germany, so it works. Okay, let's come down. Let's continue with the run. All right. So second run is for country UK, and then control goes back to the run test on given locale method. And if you see here, we have case for France, for Italy, for Germany, but not for UK. And so we don't see any change on the Firefox browser here, but if you see the console, we have a statement being printed here which says that it's not a valid test country. All right. And now we will continue with the execution again. Alright, so we have a for loop here where we are printing all the country values. So we can see them on console now. We have all the values being printed here, which are France, Italy, Germany and UK. And then we have our last set of statements wherein we are calling search country attribute. So here we are passing UK, and when control goes here, then there are two searches being performed, which are on language and capital. So let's see this as well. I'll keep a debug point here so browser is not closed. Yeah, English and London, and you saw that. And then at last we shut down the browser. We shut down the driver. Alright. So this is how we can use enum in our test classes. Later on in next session we will see how we can use enum to use browser cases, wherein we can say on which browser test should be run. Let's go back to our content and see if we missed anything. Now we covered enum with and without parameter. We created an enum in IntelliJ. We iterated through values of enum. We saw instance initialization. Let me repeat instance initialization once again if it was confusing. So we have instance initialization here, wherein we initialize the Firefox driver. We did it in two curly braces. But it's not necessary to do this. You could as well create a constructor. It's just an example to do this. And then we had a look at switch statement, and of course, as usual, the Selenium example. So this brings us to an end of this session. I hope you find it educational, and if you like it, if you find it worthy, then please hit the like button. Thanks. See you in next session. Good luck with learning. Hello and welcome to 6 Java training video. And in this video, as again, we are going to focus on the aspect of Java which are required to be able to work with Selenium. So let's see what we are going to learn in this tutorial. We will have a look at interfaces in Java, how we can implement an interface, how we can override methods of an interface. We will also see how we can use interface type instead of the class type which we have been using so far. We will also see how we can downcast and couple of Selenium examples. So let's begin. What is interface in Java? So we had explored interface in couple of previous tutorials as well, and we had described that interface is a contract between different classes. That is the class which implements an interface and the interface which is defined itself. Now, how do we declare an interface? So just right click on a package, say new, and say class, give it a name and select interface and say okay. So I have already declared an interface here which is page. The declaration begins as public interface, which is a keyword and name of the interface, followed by a couple of methods. So here we have one method which is search, and if you see, this method does not have any body. So we have a parameter which is passed to a method and then semicolon. So method is blank, there is no body for this method. And this is where implementation comes into the picture. So all the classes which implement the page interface will have to implement the search method. So we have two different methods here, two different classes here which implement the page interface. Let's see those classes. So first class is Google Homepage. So we declare this class as public class, name of the class, and then we have to say implements. Implements means this method is going to implement the interface page. Now this method has two instance variables which are WebDriver and SearchBox. SearchBox is the Google search box which we see on the search page or the home page, and WebDriver is an interface which comes from Selenium. Now if you notice here, we have a difference here that so far we were using the Firefox driver instance, Firefox driver class, but now we are using the WebDriver here, which if I double click on it, you can see here that this is an interface, it's not a class. So now we are using the type WebDriver. We will see why it is more useful a little later. Now let's see the constructor of this class, which is Google Homepage, and in this constructor we are initializing the WebDriver instance variable, which happens here. Alright, now we have the search method here. So if you see, IDA indicates it by a symbol I, and it says that it implements the method in interface inheritance page, which is the search method. So this method is implemented in the Google Homepage class. So we come to the implementation here, where we have a couple of print statements, and then we have one print statement which says that search on Google Homepage using search data, the data, the parameter which is passed to a method. And then we have a couple of methods being invoked from WebDriver, which has find element method. We pass the argument as by object for the search box, which is Google search box here, and then we clear it. And then we pass the test data to the search box. Now if you see here, we are not using the Firefox driver here, we are using the interface here. So we are invoking these methods on interface. The advantage here is that we can use the same steps here to run the test on any of the WebDriver implementation, be it Internet Explorer or Chrome or Safari or Firefox. So our test is not limited to be able to be run only on Firefox driver here. And this is the advantage of using WebDriver interface and not a specific implementation of WebDriver. Alright, so this was one implementation of interface page in Java. And then we have another implementation, which is Google search result page. This is similar to the Google homepage which we saw earlier. But the difference here is that we have a different method here. So we have the search method being implemented, of course, because this class also implements the page class, but we have a new method here, which is getResultSet. This method is not defined in the interface. So the class which implements an interface can have its own method. And in this case, Google search result page class has its own method. And what does this method do? We will see later when I run this tutorial that we have result statistics. There is one field called result statistics which shows how many results are returned by Google for the search term, and this is something which we are retrieving using this method. So we are again using the WebDriver instance here, not a specific browser but the type interface here. We say find element, using the result stats via locator, and then we get the text out of here. Alright, now let's see how we are using these classes. So these classes are being run here in the test class. These classes are being used in the test class, and test class has a couple of more configuration. So test class also has an instance variable of type WebDriver, and then we have a method called initDriver in which we are initializing the driver. Now initDriver takes parameter of type enum browser. We had seen enum in the previous session, so let's see what's there in this enum. Yeah, so browser is an enum here, and we have three values for this: Firefox, IE, and Chrome, namely FF, IE, and Chrome, and then control goes back to the initDriver. Now depending on the browser, we are creating the instance of a web driver. So if we have Chrome browser, then we say web driver equal to new Chrome driver, and then we break it. Otherwise, for Firefox, we instantiate Firefox, or for Chrome, or for IE, we instantiate IE. If we get a browser type which we do not know, then we just print that is an invalid browser. Following this, we have a wait statement which we had seen earlier also. Now we have a launch app method which is used to launch the Google homepage, and a shutdown method which would be used to shut down the browser. Then we have a method to perform search on Google homepage. So let's see what's happening in this method. This method takes a parameter called test data, and here we are creating, or we are instantiating, the Google homepage class which we saw here, the first class which implements the page interface. And now instead of assigning it to Google homepage class, we are assigning it to interface. And this is of type interface. This is where we are instantiating the class, but we are assigning it to base type. We are not assigning it to Google homepage. And then we are using this object to perform the search. Now if I try to find where search is, so search is on page interface. So here, which implementation of search would be invoked is not known at the compile time. So runtime, when this object is really created, then we will see that it invokes the search implementation in the Google homepage class. Alright, let's see what more methods we have. We have search on search result page now, wherein we are instantiating the Google search result page class, which was our second class, and then we are invoking the search method here. Here again, compiler does not know which implementation of search would be called. It is only during runtime that compiler finds out we have Google search result page class. Alright. And then we have get search result statistics, another method here. Let's see what's happening in this method. We are again creating an instance of Google search result page class, and we are assigning it to page interface. And then we have a string variable which is null. Now we know that we have a get result set method which is defined in Google search result page class, so we cannot invoke it from the page instance here. The reason being, the method is available only in the Google search result page class. So what do we do to get to the access, to get the access of the, to get access of the get result set method? We write it in one if block to find out if page is instance of Google search result page, and if so, then we are downcasting it. That is, we are changing it from a specific type page, from a base type page or a general type page, to a specific type Google search result page. How do we do that? We write page, and in front of this we write a specific class, and then we can call the get result set method. This is what we are assigning it to the string, and then we return it. So since get result set is not available in the page interface, it's in the Google search result page class, we have to downcast page to a specific type. And finally, we have the main method. So in main method, we instantiate our test class, we declare browser as Firefox, we initialize the driver. So since we declare browser as Firefox, when control comes to init driver, then case FF is executed because browser type is Firefox here. And then we are calling the search Google homepage, and then search on search result page, and then we are printing the search result statistics. So let's run it and see. So I am going to debug this method so that we can see what actions are carried out. Here comes the browser. Alright, so first debug point is reached. Alright, so control comes to search on Google homepage. And then we have search being carried out here. So let's see what happens when I continue here. Yeah, so here we have black box testing being used because this is the test data which we are passing here. Then I carry out the next search, which is search on search result page, which is with white box testing. So white box testing is typed here. And then we are finally printing the result statistics. So this is the result statistics here, which is in German. So this would be printed here. Yeah, so this is what is printed here. Let me maximize it again. Yeah, so first we have search on Google homepage, which comes from this statement, which is called here. And if you see, I had said that we do not know compile time, which implementation of search is called, but during runtime, it is going to be the Google homepage instance, which is invoked. The search method is invoked from here, which is why we have search on Google homepage printed here. Alright, and in the next statement, we have search on search result page. So control comes here, and then control goes to Google search result page class, and then this search implementation is called here. Hence, we have search on Google search result page being printed, and our search term there was white box testing. Finally, we have get search result statistics, which is our last line, and this is printed here. And this is the search result statistics that is in 0.16 second. Google found millions of results, which is quite common for Google. Alright, so we had a look at following things here: interface, implementing an interface, overriding methods in interface, using interface type, downcasting, and Selenium example. I think I forgot to mention the overriding part of it. So when we were implementing the interface, we have this override annotation, which is from the compiler, and it means that the method which is being written here is going to override the method which is in the interface type. So if I just click on this symbol, it says implements method in interface and inheritance.page, and if I click on it, then control goes there. Yeah, that's about it. So this brings us to an end of this session. I hope you find it educational, and if you like it, then please click on the thumbs up on YouTube. Thank you. Happy learning. Good luck.